Good day everyone, welcome to my channel. So in this video guys, we will talk about what is gout. Before we start, I would like to say thank you so much to all my viewers, silent viewers and supporters in my channel. Thank you for watching my videos. If you are new with my channel and then you like this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to share and please support my channel guys if you are new by clicking the subscribe button. So let's begin. One of the most common form of arthritis that everybody's know or almost everybody in this world experience is gout. So according to clevelandclinic.org, gout is a painful form of arthritis when your body has extra uric acid. Sharp crystals can form in your joints, usually your big toe. Flare-ups of symptoms like pain and swelling come and go in periods called gout attacks. Treatment is usually a combination of symptom management and changing your diet. So basically, gout is a lifestyle, no, type of disease, no. So we have here some overview what is gout, no. So gout is a form of inflammatory arthritis that causes pain and swelling in your joints. Gout happens when there is a buildup of uric acid in your body. So gout, I'm not a medical expert, but based on my experience having a gout, this form of arthritis affected everyone, men and women or even children, no? So in my case, I have a gout because of it is hereditary, no? It runs in the family. So gout most commonly affects your big toe joint. It can affect other joints including your knees, ankles, feet, hands and wrists, elbows. Gout symptoms come and go or occur in episodes called flares or gout attacks. A healthcare provider will suggest medications and changes to your diet that will lower your uric acid levels and minimize how often you experience gout attacks in the future. So we need to go to a medical practitioner like doctors or rheumatologist for them to evaluate our state of our health, no, if we are having a gout, no. So we have here some symptoms and causes of gout. What are our gout symptoms, no? So according to this website, gout attacks are very painful and can happen suddenly, often overnight. During a gout attack, symptoms in your affected joints may include intense pain, excruciating pain, no? Some of my, when I was first diagnosed with gout at the age of 26 years old, I cannot stand up, I cannot walk. That's the pain that I have experienced, no? Discoloration or redness in the big toe, stiffness, swelling, tenderness, or even a light touch like a bed sheet covering your affected joint. Very painful, warm, or a feeling like the joint is on fire. So how long does a gout attack last? Gout attacks usually last a week or two. You might have some flares that last longer than others. So in some might cause more severe symptoms. Between attacks, you may not experience any gout symptoms. So the next questions that we have tried to answer is, what causes gout? Very good question. According to the article, a buildup of excess uric acid in your body causes gout. Your body naturally makes uric acid. It breaks down chemicals called purines found in certain foods and drinks. Your kidneys usually filter uric acid out of your blood and then it leaves your body when you pee, no? Going to the comfort room. Sometimes your body makes too much uric acid or your kidneys don't remove it from your blood fast enough. When your body has high levels of uric acid or hyperuricemia, uric acid crystals can build up and settle in your joints. The sharp crystals clump together and cause sudden episodes of pain, swelling, and other symptoms. Having temporarily high uric acid levels doesn't mean you definitely develop gout. Many people with hyperuricemia never get gout. Now, let us talk about what are the risk factors of having a gout. Gout can affect anyone. So there is no exemption. There are no bases in terms of race, age, etc. People assigned male at birth, AMAB, are 3 times more likely to develop gout. People assigned with female at birth, AFAB, usually don't experience gout until after menopause. People with a certain health conditions are more likely to develop gout, including, so there is a risk factor, overweight or obesity, congestive heart failure, diabetes, hypertension, high blood pressure, kidney disease, blood cancer. You're more likely to experience gout if you have a biological parent or grandparent who has gout, hereditary, as I said earlier in my case. Eat a lot of animal proteins, especially animal flesh, shellfish, and foods that contain organ meat. Drink alcohol regularly. Take a diuretic medication, water pills. Take immunosuppressants. So which food cause gout? Eating or drinking foods high in purines are more likely to lead to high uric acid levels in your body that cause gouts, including sugary drinks and sweets. Standard table sugar is half fructose, fruit sugar, with breakdowns into a uric acid. Any food or drink with high sugar content can trigger gout. Second, we have here high fructose corn syrup. This is a concentrated form of fructose. Packaged food products and processed snacks can contain lots of high fructose corn syrup. This kind of fructose is much cheaper compared to the traditional sugar, no? From the sugar cane in terms of cost, no? So that's why many manufacturers, especially the soft drinks, much prefer high fructose, no? Or fructose type syrup compared to sugar because they can save a lot of money in terms of manufacturing. Alcohol, even though not all alcoholic drinks are high in purines, alcohol prevents your kidney from eliminating uric acid, pulling it back into your body where it continues to accumulate. We have also here organ meats. These include liver, tripe, sweatbreads, brains, and kidneys. Game meats, specialties such as goose, vial, and venison all contain high levels of purines. Certain seafood, herring, scallops, mussels, codfish, tuna, trout, and haddock. Red meat, beef, lamb, pork, and bacon. So if you want to eat, just minimize, no? Or a small portion only. Turkey, specially processed daily turkey, gravy, and meat sauces. So diagnosis and test. Now, how is gout diagnosed? A healthcare provider will diagnose gout with a physical exam. They ask you about your symptoms and examine your affected joints. Tell your provider when you first notice symptoms like pain and swelling in your joint and how often the symptoms come and go. What tests will be done to diagnose gout? Your healthcare provider might use a few imaging tests to take pictures of your affected joints. This test also show if gout has caused any changes in your joints. You might x-ray, ultrasound, magnetic resonance imaging or MRI, a CT or scan, computed tomography, especially in dual energy CT scan. Other common tests to diagnose include, we have your blood test to measure the uric acid in your blood, joint aspiration using a needle to remove sample of fluid from inside a joint now. So the next question is, how we manage in treatment of gout? How is gout treated? Treating gout usually is a combination of managing your symptoms during a flare and reducing how often you consume high purine foods and drinks. So we have here gout medication. Your healthcare provider might suggest medication to help manage your symptoms, including NSAIDs, over-the-counter medicine, colchicine, a medication that can reduce inflammation and pain if you take it within 24 hours of a gout attack. Corticosteroid, no? So for pain also, no? So we have also here common medication, allopurinol, to lower down the uric acid, febuxostat, piglosicase, probicin, and then most importantly, guys, eat a low purine diet, no? So in order to avoid, no? So sadly, no, gout is no cure, no? So it can be it can return any moment from now. What is important is how we manage, you know, this disease. Okay, so I guess, no, this is the end of my report on what is gout is all about. A very interesting topic, no? For those people, including yours truly, having this kind of disease. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. I hope that you have learned something new in this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to share and please support my channel, guys. If you're new, be clicking the subscribe button. See you in the next video tutorial, guys. This is your friend Jake saying bye-bye for now.